Yo, what's up? My name is the Kid LAROI. I'm 17 years old. I'm from Sydney, Australia, and I'm an artist.
Growing up, moving around a lot and going through so many different things, it was definitely stressful and hard for me as a young kid trying to figure out how I was going to change something because I felt like everybody around me, they didn't want to change. So I felt like if I wanted something to change in my life, then I had to go and get it myself. It was stressful, but it motivated me a lot.
For life!
Ever since I was young, I always tried to rap. Like, I was always writing rap lyrics and stuff like that, and I'd always record myself on the phone. I always had, like, a mindset that if I want to make something happen, I can make it happen. Growing up, my mom and I bonded over music. My mom played a lot of, like, Erykah Badu and Tupac, Kanye, all that type of stuff, so I just picked up a lot of that stuff. I started going through certain things and relating the lyrics and stuff to my own life, and then I started thinking, like, oh, maybe I could do this. When I watched the Tupac, the Dear Mama video, or the Brandon's Got a Baby video, and I was like, oh, damn, this is crazy. I love this. And I was super, super, super young, too, but I, like, understood it. That's one of the things that made me want to do music. I definitely think I get my work ethic from my mom. You know, being able to turn nothing into something in terms of, like, when we didn't have a lot of money, being able to find ways to get money and send me and my brother to a nice school. I saw that, and that was always embedded into me. I guess watching my mom do that gave me a super, like, hustler mentality.
Huge. I hope you realize what's going to happen to you in 2021. You're going to be one of the biggest artists in the whole wide world. Your music is so great.
Thank you, it means so much coming from you.
Elton John, that was pretty crazy. Justin Bieber following me on Instagram. To be honest, I don't really, like, focus too much on that stuff because it doesn't even all the way feel real, so I kind of just keep it moving. Ever since the Without You song started going up, I'm seeing, like, all the different videos that people make.
So there you go, oh, can't make a wife out of a hoe, oh, and I'll never find the words to say I'm sorry, but I'm scared to be alone.
That's super funny, I love it.
It's crazy, and I feel so lucky and blessed that all those different people follow me and support my songs, but at the same time, like, I don't focus on it too much. I'm more focused on, like, real life. I write for myself, and I'm happy that people like what I write. It's not something that I necessarily expect, but it's a blessing to be able to have that.
It's important for me to highlight and try and give recognition to upcoming artists in Australia because I feel like when I was making music growing up, I felt like I didn't have anybody to, like, look up to that was from Australia. Like, oh, that's my guy from my country. Like, that's really doing it. So I guess I want to be able to come back and, like, be what I wanted for myself back then for other kids. That's one of my biggest goals in the whole music thing, is to show people what Australia's really got, because I feel like sometimes it could be overlooked, but it's a lot of raw and unseen talent that the world needs to hear about. The reasons I rhyme is to get my feelings out, because I hate talking about my feelings. My number one goal in music is to be the biggest artist in the world. I want to be further in my career. I want to make better music. I want to be a better version of myself. I want to be able to inspire as many people as I can and accomplish all the things I want to accomplish in my life.